Here's something that at first looks like a 1990s era sports car, although you can't quite make out exactly what make and model it's supposed to be. The front end looks very Japanese, very Mazda RX-7-esque, with the pop-up headlights and these lights in the front that allow you to flash your headlights without popping them up. If you ever wonder what those white lights on the front of a car with pop-up headlights are, that's what they are for. In case you need to flash your headlights, instead of having to quickly open and close the headlights, it just flashes through the lenses here. It says 5000, but obviously this is not an Audi 5000. Not in any shape or form. The side starts to look a little Corvette-esque with the way the rear window wraps around to the side. Although strangely it has wire wheels, which you don't normally see on a car like this. The side profile though starts to look a little more Italian, like a Ferrari or something, with the way the front wheels create a little bump in the hood because it's so low. It needs to have a little bulge there where the wheels are, and the way it sort of sweeps up towards the back. But then it has this strange full-width amber taillight. Now obviously no car in reality would have a completely amber taillight because it needs to have red lenses for the brake lights and taillights and white lenses for the backup lights. And I like how it has a exhaust outlet there. And this full-width taillight was kind of confusing me. I couldn't quite make out what kind of car it's supposed to be like. But then I realized it's vaguely similar to two early 1990s cars. They were kind of more of sporty cars than strictly sports cars. That is the Oldsmobile Toronado and the Buick Riata. They both had a full-width taillight lens like this.
Here I have a 1988 Buick Riata, a two-door coupe dramatically designed, departed from anything standard that Buick had ever done. Later on, they came with a convertible version, by far one of the more unique vehicles Buick has ever produced.
The logo on the hood kind of looks like a Q, but again, that doesn't really look like the logo of any automaker. But if this is supposed to be a remote control toy car, you kind of wonder why it has an AC power cord attached, because obviously it wouldn't get very far plugged in like that. But obviously this is not a toy car, even though it kind of looks like one. It's a VHS tape rewinder. Those of you who watched movies on VHS tape, of course, remember having to rewind the tape when you were done watching it. Otherwise, when you returned it, you would be charged a fine. And if you didn't want to put extra wear and tear on your VCR rewinding a tape, that's why they sold these dedicated devices to do it. And especially back in the day when VCRs were rather slow to rewind. Later in the 90s, they came out with those flash rewind VCRs, like the one I did a video about, which would get very fast when rewinding a tape. It would take only about a minute to rewind the tape. So by that time, these things kind of fell out of favor. But back in the late 80s, early 90s, VHS rewinders were very popular, and they even had some which would also fast forward. And they sold videotape rewinders for other formats as well, including Betamax, and in this case 8mm. This one can also fast forward. So you pop in your tape and you can fast forward or rewind. It even has a little tape counter there. So let's try out the VHS rewinder. I have it plugged in. Pop it open, and it's kind of hard to make out, but there is writing on the sunroof here which says flap side faces right. So that's the way I'm going to put in the tape. And there it goes, rewinding. Not exactly the fastest rewinder, but it did free up your VCR in case you want to start watching another tape while you waited for this one to rewind. And you can see, it even has little lights that light up in there. So that's kind of cool. Don't know if there's any in the back. Doesn't look like it. So here there's none in the back where they burned out. And when it's done rewinding, it's going to pop up the tape automatically. So that's pretty cool. The 1990s sports car VHS tape rewinder. Unfortunately, there's no manufacturer's name anywhere on it. Just on the bottom, I notice it says, not a toy. Also has an artifact of where a voltage selector switch would go, but there's nothing there. And there's nothing really interesting to look at inside, just a bunch of plastic and a spindle that the tape goes on, and of course there's going to be a motor in there. So now I can watch my video professor tape and learn how to use Microsoft Word for Windows version 6.
Welcome to the Video Professor's series of computer learning tapes, the nation's number one computer trainer. We'll take you step by step through learning to use your computer software. On the screen now are some other tapes available in our series. When using these tapes, we suggest you watch them in their entirety, then go back with your computer and practice each step. In keeping with the Video Professor's dedication to giving you the best lesson possible, we have packed these tapes with information and sometimes move at a pace that is faster than you will be able to follow along with as you are working with your computer. Remember, you can always pause or rewind the tape to learn each part. Now let's get started. And welcome to my Level 2 lesson on Microsoft Word 6.0 for Windows. As we go through this lesson together, we'll look at the tools that help us develop documents using fewer steps and less time. In this tape, we will concentrate on the Word 6.0 tools that help shape and enhance the look of your documents. You'll learn to work with character formats, margins, indents, and tabs, line spacing, alignment, and styles. In addition to those skills, we'll also learn other Word features that help us use Word to fit our style of working. Before going any further, I'd like to introduce Suzanne, my student helper for this lesson. Simply follow along with her, and you'll be using the formatting tools of this program in no time. Suzanne already has her computer on and has both Windows and Word 6.0 up and running. If you haven't done this, pause the tape and do so at this time. Later in this lesson, we'll save our work to disk. Suzanne will save her work to a floppy disk to avoid cluttering up the hard drive. I suggest you, too, have an empty formatted diskette on hand to save your video professor results, too.